Ahead of the 42nd Tarehe Sita celebrations in Bara district tomorrow, the UPDF soldiers and other sister security officers from Uganda Police and the Uganda prisons of Kabale district have paid a special tribute to the FRONASA fighters. The event, which started with a cleaning exercise at Kabale Regional Referral Hospital, was presided by the State Minister for Trade, Industries and Cooperatives, David Bahati. At the hospital, the soldiers were hailed for exhibiting a good image that shows a pro-people force. The minister later led the authorities to laying a wreath on a monument that was recently renovated by the UPDF in commemoration of the fallen FRONASA fighters who were gunned in Kabale Municipal Stadium. Bahati re-echoed government's commitment to reach out to families of the fallen heroes. He commended the UPDF for professionalism and positively impacting the country.
And because of your discipline as airmen, because of your commitment, you can see that now we are trying our level best under the leadership of President Yoweri Museveni to spread the peace in South Sudan, in Somalia, and DRC Congo. So the country and the population of Uganda is behind you. We encourage you to continue doing the best for the country.
Senator Obia Mugasha, the Kabale municipality mayor, promised to fence the monument as to protect it from destruction.
I want to thank the government for the recognition of our gallant sons who put their life to liberating Uganda. We are enjoying peace because of them, because that is the genesis of the revolution, and want to thank you for that. Maybe what I want to, as my opinion, Honourable Minister, if we could get a fence. I know my town, you know, most of the people that we have will not be, some of them will not be happy.
Relatedly, hundreds of Bulima Town Council residents in Masindi District have received free treatment from the Masindi Field Artillery Division in commemoration of the 42nd Tarehe Sita. Masindi Army Field Division Administrative Officer Colonel Alex Wabuyi explained why they were positioned at Bulima Town Council.
The purpose of coming to this area was to ensure that we see the status of the hospital, give it capacity to handle those cases, and always report to Masindi Military Hospital for onward action. And because of that purpose, we love the people of Bunyoro region, and more so on this line that connects Masindi to Hoima. These are the people who are supplying us with foodstuffs.
Some of the beneficiaries of the health camp say they've received free treatment and are thankful for the service. I have come for treatment and I have gotten the medicine, though I have not received high blood pressure medicine, but I have been tested and found that it is normal. I thank them very much. We thank the UPDF for bringing us this health camp because they've extended the services nearer. We have elderly people, and people cannot go to Masindi Town, Hoima, or Kampala for treatment. People have been diagnosed and treated for free, so I want to thank the UPDF and the government of Uganda for extending this service. And so we request that they can do it again next time. UPDF have kuija okutukonyera kandi tusaba no mulundo ogundi nabo mwijege muti mutukonye. The division also carried out general cleaning at Bulima Town Council. The Bulima Town Council Local 3 Osborne Bajuga applauded UPDF for cleaning their town. Also, the leadership of Uganda People's Defense Forces have today handed over to the leaders of Greater Mbarara districts the completed community project implemented in the region during the Army Week as part of the 42nd Tarehe Sita anniversary activities. The handover activities included symbolic monuments that were erected in recognition of those who participated in the struggle, rehabilitated and constructed infrastructure, including health facilities in the districts of Mbarara, Isinjiro, Kazo, Rampara, and Mbarara City that form Greater Mbarara.
The plaque we have unveiled today at Makenke Barracks was marking the date or the action where our visionary president, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, led a team of 330 in the 1972, fighting against Idi Amin, misrule, to change leadership. They didn't succeed, but one thing must stand out very, very prominently. They never lost hope.
When you look around, you can see that the people of Mbarara have really understood the message of the revolution, have understood the messages from our leader. They have understood why and how they should transform themselves. They have understood that when you have peace, then the ground is leveled for you to do your work.
The CPC was number two, I was number three, the mayor was the last. So that qualifies us. That qualifies the old men that can still lead. So before I leave this ground, can we all clap for President Museveni who brought this speech?
Tarehe Sita marks the day National Resistance Army, NRA rebels, launched the attack on Kabamba Barracks as part of their military campaign against the Milton Obote-led government on February 6, 1981, which later ushered in the leadership of the ruling National Resistance Movement, NRM. This year's Tarehe Sita celebrations are to be held in the Greater Mbarara region at Kachweka Stadium as part of a fulfillment of the FRONASA liberation struggle with the theme Recognizing the Sacrifice of the Founders of the People's Revolution for Socio-Economic Transformation. Report compiled by Godfrey Muhumuze, Job Namanya, and Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.